Kolkata or Calcutta, one of the most important cities in Southeast Asia. Kolkata was the capital of India until 1911 during the British rule, after which it shifted to New Delhi. People of different nations and languages had lived in this city for the age. Over time, this city has witnessed many ups and downs. There are many surprises hidden on the every page of this history which cannot be completed in a day. Kolkata is the 20th largest city in the world today, which is called the cultural capital of India.
The story of founding of city Kolkata was very popular, and it is by the Job Channel on 24th August 1690, the director of Sutanoti factory of East India Company. But great curiosity awaits. Can a city ever be in a special day? Have any example in world of history, any city built up in a day? Then what happened really on that day? Let's see. But before that, look after on the incident at 2001.
August 2001. On the basis of public interest application by Sabarna Roy Chowdhury Paribar Parishad and nine prominent intellectuals of Kolkata, a special committee of five eminent historians headed by historian Professor Nimai Sadhan Bose was constituted by Kolkata High Court. They submitted their report to the court after 6 months of research work, and 16th May 2003, a division bench of the Chief Justice Ashok Kumar Mathur and Justice Jayanta Bishwas declared this historical claim of birth at 24th August 1690 of Kolkata are wrong, because the birth of a city is no way to possible by a particular person on a particular day.
So find out the real story, we must live in 1690. On that time, India ruled by Mughal King Aurangzeb. On the Bengal seat, Ibrahim Khan, and the most of the area Kolkata belongs to Sabarna Roy Chowdhury family.
In this region, on the bank of River Ganga, a well-organized rural area of people of various professions has developed. The lands adjoining the rural area are extensive and cultivation. A number of Europeans live in the present central Kolkata region for their commercial purpose. At that time, there were two international trading points in this region, one at Sutanoti and another at Govindapur. The river Ganga was more turbulent and wavy than it is now. Apart from the countryside and the farmland, many areas are full of swamps, forests and bushes. The existence of forest is found in the present Chaurangi region, where there are some reports written during the British period about the existence of tiger, crocodile and other animals. The date was 24th August 1690. It had been raining all the day, but it was still very sultry. Mohanjuni Ghat or Mohantor Ghat of Sutanoti village, which was located near Nimtala Ghat in the North Kolkata. A few boats come and stood near the river Ghat, one of which was large boat with the British flag. The port is full by armed European and locals. A healthy man stood on the deck of the boat. He is wearing a half Spanish and half Flemish dress, a Flemish hat with a serpent on his head.
Job Channel. The high-ranking British East India Company employee arrived at Sutanoti. This is the third time he visited at Sutanoti to expand the company trade. By the order of King Aurangzeb, dated 23rd April 1690, in an agreement to trade here, annually rent rupees 3000.
Job Channel come down at Sutanoti, but this time he required a place to stay at night. He built some mud houses the previous time, some of destroyed by natural disaster, and the rest of houses has been looted and set on fire by some locals. Heavy rainfall started at the evening. That night he was forced to spend the night in the boat, as he could see no other way.
Jogcharnok rebuilded the old mud houses and resumed company's business here. When Jogcharnok arrived at Shutanoti at 1690, he was about 60 and he was very ill. After a long illness, he died at 1693, 10th January. This is the actual relationship with Kolkata and Jogcharnok and the story of 24th August 1690, which have no any connection with the birth of city Kolkata or Calcutta. After Jogcharnok, Sir John's Goldbearer appointed as a East India Company Shutanoti Factory Director at 1693 and Charles Sayer at 1696. Because of some event took places during this period that helped East India Company to become zamindar or local administrator from a common merchant, and the whole area, the whole region come to known as Calcutta. So what were those stories? I will discuss but at our next episode. If you like our video, please like it, share it, and mostly give your valuable feedback to our comment box. And don't forget to subscribe our channel. We will meet soon at our next episode. Till then, stay well.